French, even the Japanese, of course the Spanish, and then we have Americans. And when the Americans came, teka muna, senior, kaya nun yung baka kinaanon dahil history dahil senior na ako. Oh my God!
Looking up to you, Miss Nancy, for guidance.
Anyway, with the Americans, there came what we call pop culture. Through another source came the cheddar cheese, which we now have as Eden. And Eden, of course, I used that.
Part of our culture. I grew up with Eden.
So Eden represents also the pop culture that has stayed. It's very unique kasi sa Asia, tayo yung unang nagka-hamburger na may cheese, cheeseburger, nagkaroon ng grilled cheese sandwich. You ask na lang your lolo and your lola. A&W, tapos ano pa ba yung iba? What were the other restaurants then? A&W, along the way, Boulevard, of course, Aristocrat. Botica Boy. Ano mo nga nag-react? Yon, yung mga yung Botica Boy. B-O-I-E. Ayan, that was the... Yung mga, yeah, so savory, dun sa... In that, Escolta then was the Makati of Manila.
Manila was really the center at that time.
Oh, it was the social place to be. So, grilled cheese sandwich became really, really popular. And it represented the American way of being a pop culture.
But for us Filipinos, Miss Nancy, what would you say are the really famous Filipino dishes that have cheese in it, that become common to us Filipinos?
Well, Nabina, you mentioned it already, but right now the rage would be ensaymada.
Cheese.
Yeah, it's not just a breakfast thing, it's a snack, it's a pangregalo, it's a pasalubong.
Pasalubong, yes, a very Filipino tradition.
And traditionally, of course, there's the caldereta, which has to have cheese. Pag hindi cheese, hindi ka social, hindi caldereta yun. Kailangan talaga, oo, may queso.
Your neighbors will be like talking behind your back, like, oh, cheese.
Yeah. So, and then, I know you asked about adobo.
Yes. We're so, like, looking forward to this one. Because I've personally not seen adobo with cheese.
There was a, when I was having a TV show called Pinoy Foodie, sabi niya, is there anything else you can do about adobo? Okay, sabi ko, lagyan natin ng queso, adobo. So we did. I cooked chicken adobo sa lipa. That was my, we were shooting the episode. And nag-click. So pinick up na maraming nagtanong after that sa... After that episode. So I guess it's becoming a part of the,
culture,
of the culture, yeah. The culinary, the pop culture.
And could you be able to share with us here who want to try to make the adobo? Just adding cheese? Or do you have something special, trick?
Wala na, just add grated cheese. Make your kids eat it.
Right?
Yeah.
So right, this June 4, since you know that it's gonna be the National Cheese Day, if you're gonna try to cook adobo, then make sure you tag Eden Cheese with hashtag Cheese Goodness so we can all see what you've been cooking. Because I'm super curious what you're gonna make.
Later if you ask me na lang. What other dishes kaya do I think
can be made?
Can accept or can be benefited by cheese?
I'm super curious.
Marami!
Yeah,
naisip ko lang kanina. Kasi yung cheese, kasi it's a fixer-upper eh. Diba? Ayaw kumain ng anak mo ng gulay, lagyan mo ng cheese! Ayaw kumain ng sapaw, lagyan mo ng konting cheese! You don't have to put a lot. It's over naman yun. You just put the, and it feels good. It feels, kasi comfort food ang cheese eh. It's not just something for the stomach. It makes you feel good na siguro goes back to the peacetime, to creaminess, to umami, easy to cook, easy to eat. Cut the cheese, you don't even have to cut it into cheese.
Snack on it.
Pantisal pa lang eh, di ba? Hindi na kailangan yung mga itlog-itlog dyan. Yun na yun. Okay na siya.
Cheesy crackers. Thank you for that, Miss Nancy. We really appreciate your time here. And for us to know more about what Eden Cheese is planning for us this year, let us call in the assistant brand manager, Mr. Raf Baradas, to give us more information.